Good morning, Grade 8. Welcome back to another interesting journey into the world of data mining. Oh, I always forget to introduce myself. My name is Mr. Suriman, and I work in the Johannesburg North District. But welcome, guys, into another interesting lesson in the world of data handling, or more commonly known as statistics. So are you ready? Let's get started. Today, we're going to look at measures of central tendency, right? Measures of central tendency. So what do we mean by that? Already the word central should give you an idea what we might have to deal with. Something which is more or less in the middle or in the center. Am I correct? A measure of central tendency, also referred to as measures of center or central location. Aha, you see? So I was right. Somewhere in the middle or in the center. You see? It is a summary measure that attempts to describe a whole set of data with a single value, represents the middle or center of its distribution. See, the idea is, guys, that if you have a lot of data, now, let's say, for instance, we look at your June, the grade 8A's June math results, and the sir wants to determine more or less how have you done. So what you will do is, you will write down all your marks, and you will see where are most of the learners. Are most of the marks at the bottom? Are most of the marks in the middle? Or are most of the marks right on top? In other words, are most of the learners got distinctions? Or most of them got average marks? Or most of them maybe haven't done that well? I don't want to say fail. Haven't done it well. So this is the idea, to see more or less where is the center of the mark. So are we ready? There are three main measures of central tendency. Now there are three ways of determining the center or the average mark. This is the other word you can use. We're looking at the average, more or less. But there's three ways of doing it. You can either do what we call the mode, or you can do what we call the median, or we can call it, or we can find the mean. So the mode, the median, or the mean. Those are the three ways to find the average, more or less, the results. Right. Each of these measures describes a different indication of the typical or central value in the distribution. Right. So each of them will describe, but as we go along, you will see when to use which one. Right. So remember now, the idea of central means somewhere in the middle. Where is the middle mark, more or less? Right. Let's first start with the mode. What is the mode? Spelled M-O-D-E. The mode is the number in your data that occurs the most. Right, it occurs the most. You can also say the mode is the value that has the highest frequency. By frequency, we mean that occurs the most, that appears most of the time. This the frequency, right? So mode, in other words, is the number in your data that occurs most often. Sometimes two scores occur equally, and then the data set has more than one mode. So it is possible for data to have more than, for instance, say number 5 appears 3 times, and the number 6 also appears 3 times, so their appearance or the frequency are exactly the same. So therefore, they are both the mode. So in that case, we will say the data set is bimodal. So if there's two values which occur the same amount or the same frequency, it is then bimodal. If there are more than two modes, sometimes it's possible that three or four values can appear the same. Then we say the data is multimodal. Right, so there can be one mode, there can be two, which we call bimodal, or there can be more than two, which we call multimodal. So please, guys, remember those terms. Right, okay. Other times, there might not be any number that occurs more than often than any other number. This is then said as no mode. So it is possible, guys, that all the numbers appear or their frequency are the same. The one doesn't appear more than the other one, so there's no mode then. Right, so therefore, no mode. The clear one. So remember now, there can be one mode, there can be two, which you call bimodal, or there can be more than two, which you call multimodal, or there can be no mode. So please bear that in mind. All right. Let's look at the example. Our first example on mode. Now, for each of these sets of scores, you must find the mode. So again, remember what is mode? The number that appears more frequently. Look at the one. There's only one one. You agree with me? Five. There's only 1 7. There's only 1 2 3 9. Okay. There are 3 9s. There's only 1 4. Am I correct? Yes. There's only 2 3s. There's only 1 5. And there's only 1 2. Please double check with me. Make sure. So it seems like the 9s appear the most. So therefore, the mode is therefore 9. The mode is 9 because 9 appears 3 times. The 3 only appears twice. So therefore, the mode is 9. I'm sure you could have done that one. Right, the next one. Let's look at the 3. I see 1 2 3s. Right. Three. 1 2. There are 3 3s. The 7s, only 1 7. So I just scratch it out. There are 1 2 9s. 3 9s. Okay. 1 2 3 9s. There's only 1 4, so I can ignore it. There's only 1 5, I can ignore it. And there's only 1 2, so I can ignore it. So it seems like there's 3 3s and 3 9s. Okay, so that should be, yes, you're right, bimodal. It is bimodal. It is bimodal, and the modes are a 9 and a 3. All right, so there you are. Bimodal. Are we okay with it? Right, the last one. There's only 1 1, 1 2, 1 3, 1 4, 1 5, 1 6, 1 7, 1 8, 1 9. Okay, so that means what? That it is no modal. Right. No modal. Remember what I told you early on? Right? Right. No modal. Because, if I can just take you back quickly, right? Remember what I told you? No mode if one number doesn't appear more than the other one, then there's no mode. So please bear that in mind. Okay, I'll be fine with it. So remember now how to do mode. It is a number that appears most frequency. All right. Time for your activity. Right. The following data set contains the ages of 10 learners. Right. 10 learners. Right. 10 learners. 9, 15, 9, 15, 17, 15, 11, 18, 15, 19. This is double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, there are 10 learners. Right. So those are the different ages. So what must you do with this data? You must order the ages from the smallest to the biggest. So you must arrange them, in other words, from smallest to biggest. That's your first instruction. Secondly, how many learners are 9 years old? You must answer that question. What is the highest age? That's your third question. How many learners are older than 15? How many learners are 15 years old? Exactly 15. And which age occurs the most often? So here we have to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 questions. All right. So I want you to do this either on your own or get a partner next to you and you can do it together. So I want you to do it starting now. Right, welcome back, guys. Let's see whether you could get 100%. I'm sure you did, definitely. Right, let's see the first one. You must order the ages from the smallest to the biggest. So the smallest one here, let's see, 9. Is it 9, guys? Yes. So it is 9. Scratch it out. And there's another 9, don't forget. Right. So we've got 2 9s. Then the next one should be 11. Right. Only 1 11. Am I correct? Yes. Then 15. Yeah. So there's 1 2 3 15. So it is 15 15 and 15. So 3 15. 1 2 3. No, it's 4. Oh my goodness. There are 4 15s. Double check with me. 1 2 3 4 15s. I nearly made a blunder. Then the next number should be 17. There's only 1. Right. 17. Then 1 18 and 1 19. Right. Let's count. Do we have all 10? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Please double check, because you might just miss out, like I really missed out the 1 15. So please be careful. Right, so there you are. We've ordered or arranged the values from the smallest to the biggest. I'm sure you could have done that. Right, the second question. Right. How many learners are 9 years old? How many? Well, you can see, it's so easy. You can see there's 2 learners, right? So, right. So there are 2 learners, right, who are 9 years old. What is the highest age? Also easy, guys, because it will be the 19, obviously, isn't it? Because it is the biggest number. So there you are. The highest age is 19 years. How many learners are older than 15? Let's see. Older than 15? Not 15, older. And it will be those 3 there. Am I correct? So how many? There are 3 learners older than 15. How many learners are exactly 15 years old? How many? 1 2 3 4. So there are 4 learners who are exactly 15 years old. What age occurs most often? And that means what? The frequency, the highest frequency, which means the most, am I correct? Which is 4. And it is the 15, isn't it? So therefore, the most is the 15. You agree with me? Because there are 4 15s. Oh, and there's, which age occurs the most often? I'll say here, sorry. Here I'll just write a 15. Sorry, guys. And here I will say the most, right? The most is then 15. Right. So those two questions are very much the same. You see, more or less, it's a different way of asking the same question. I'm sure you guys could have done that. Brilliant. All right. So I'm sure you're okay with that. Right. Let's look now at the next mean of central tendency, and it is called the mean. Right, that's the next one. Remember, we've just done the mode, now we do the mean. Now, the mean is also known as the arithmetic mean or average. Some people say arithmetic, some say arithmetic. It's a matter of pronunciation. Right, but I prefer to say arithmetic. So, this is a bit different from mode. To determine the mean, you add, very important, you add all the scores together and divide the sum by the number of scores. Those are the important things, guys. So you add, you divide by the number of scores. Those are the 3 important things you must take note of, right? Which makes it different from the mode. The 4 formula we can use for mean is, there you are, sum of all the scores. So there you are. I talk about add, remember? Add means sum. I'm sure you remember that. So sum of all the scores, divide a division line means divide, remember? Number of scores. Right. So it's not a difficult formula to remember. The sum of all the numbers is calculated by adding all the numbers together. And just for interest, guys, the Greek alphabet, we also have this little symbol. It is called sigma. Sigma. And it just means the sum of. So sometimes if you see that symbol in a textbook, don't be surprised. Sigma just means the sum of. So just remember it. Right. Okay. Right. Let's look at the example. Right. We must find the mean of the following scores. So there are the scores, and we must find the mean. Are you ready? So remember, the formula is, right, that mean, right, is equal to, remember, the sum of the scores. Remember I said that new word, that new symbol, sigma, so you can say sigma n means the sum of all the scores divided by the amount of data, or how many numbers are there. I will tell you that now. So that sigma means the sum of divided by so many values. So shall we do it? So in our example, we have 1 plus 7 plus 9 plus 4 plus 3 plus 5 plus 9 plus 3 plus 2 plus 8 divided by, now how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Please double check with me. Are there 10 values? So divide by 10. Right, some mental math. This is a calculator. Let's do this in our head. 1 plus 7 is 8, plus 9 is 17, plus 4 is 21, plus 3 is 24, plus 5 is 29, plus 9 is 38, plus 3 is 41, plus 2 is 43, plus 8 is 51. Double check with me, okay? If you don't believe me, double check, double check, double check. Okay, use a calculator if you don't believe me. But it should be 51. I trust my brain. Or let's do it from the back, maybe. 8 plus 2 is 10. So it's 8, 10, 13, 22, 27, 30, 34, 43, 43, 50, 51. Yes. And of course, remember, a short method to divide by 10, you shift the decimal comma. So therefore, the answer should be 5,1. Remember, you divide by 10, you shift the comma once to the left-hand side. Oh, okay, use a calculator if you're not sure. So there you are, guys. How to find the mean. And I'm sure you could have done that. Right. Let's look at the activity. Right. 5 learners, ages are given. 5 learners, ages are given. And you must find the first, the sum of the ages. So you must, in other words, add up the ages. And then you must work out the mean. Right. So the, can you link it to the formula? All right. I'm sure you can do it. So please, guys, try to do it without a calculator. Right. So please do it now. Starting now. Yeah, welcome back, guys. Let's see, could you do it? All right, I'm sure you could have managed that. I don't think you had a problem. Let's see. Just extend my patience quickly. All right. What is the sum of the ages? So shall we do that quickly? Right. Remember the sum, the symbol for sum? Sigma. You remember, guys? So the sum means I must add up all those values. So it will be 9 plus 15 plus 11 plus 18 plus 19. And let's see, what do we get? Remember, they asked you for the sum. So please, guys, answer the question. Don't jump into the formula, because that wasn't asked, remember? They asked you for the sum, so you give the sum. I'm sure you're okay with it. Shall we add? Right, 9 plus 8 is 17, plus 1 is 18, plus 5 is 23, so it's 28, carry 2. 3, 4, 5. Please double check with me. I get 58. Double check with me. 9 plus 8 is 17, is 18, is 23. I think that's a mistake. Let's use a calculator. Let's use a calculator. Just to double check. So it is 9. We just got cancel here. So we have 9 plus 15 plus 11 plus 18 plus 19. Just double check with me. 9 plus 15 plus 11 plus yeah, 9 further. 9 plus 15 plus 11 plus 18 plus 19 equals 72. Oh my goodness me, I made a mistake. Are there two midgets here? 9, that's 9 plus 15 plus 11 plus 18 plus 19. Okay, so the answer here is 72. I apologize, guys, for me being so silly sometimes, but okay, there you are. So that was the first question. The second question is, what is the mean? And now, of course, you know you need to use the formula for the mean, right? So the formula for the mean is mean equals to the sum over the amount of values. And already we do have the sum is 72. And we have how many values? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Please double check with me. 5. And that should give us, quickly, again, mental math. 5 into 7, 1, carry 2, into 22, 4 times, that's 20, and 2 left. Right, so 5 into 20, 4. So according to the calculator, it should be 14.4. Again, you can double check my mathematics, am I correct or not? Unless you can again try the calculator, why not? Let's see. Let's see. Right, cancel. 72, we can use the fraction key, right, which is so convenient. 72, scroll down, 5, scroll out, and equals to, well, there's a common, an improper fraction, which is 14.4. So, yes, I was 100% correct. All right, so please, guys, again, important, you must follow instructions, right? All right. Now we go to the third and last means of central tendency. We've done mode, mean, and now the third one is median. Are you ready? What is median? Median is a set of data, the number right in the middle of the order set. So it must be in the middle, and the data must be ordered. In other words, you must arrange the data from smallest to biggest or biggest to smallest. Doesn't really matter. But as long as you order them, because that is important, guys. That has to be done for us to be able to see which value lies in the middle. Remember, we went to a central tendency. So what is in the middle? Very important. If there's an odd number of scores, what are odd numbers again? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. Those are odd numbers, isn't it? And even numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I'm sure you remember. So if there's an odd number, right, the median is right in the middle. Shouldn't be a problem. However, if there's an even number of scores, then the two numbers, there will be two numbers in the middle, guys. Two will lie in the middle, I promise you. And then you need to add them and divide by 2. But don't worry, in the example, I'm going to show you. Right. Let's look at the example. What is the median of each of the following set of numbers? Right, let's look at the first one. Remember, you must first order the numbers, so you must arrange them from smallest to biggest, or biggest to smallest, it is up to you. So let's start, I prefer from the smallest. So the smallest number here is 1, so 1 is done. Then 2 is the next one, and then 3, then 4, oh, wait a second, there's another 3, did you see, guys? Don't forget, there's another 3, then the 4, then the 5, okay, is there a 6? No, but there is a 7, and there's an 8, and there's a 9. Let's double check. How many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Please double check your answer, guys. Please, please, please. Are we okay with that now? Brilliant. Right. Now, we must find the median. Now, where is the median? Remember we said, in the middle, and is this an odd number? Yes, so it should be in the middle. If I count, 1 there, 1 there. 2 there, 2 there. 3 there, 7 there. 3 there, 5 there. So I got 4 on the left-hand side, and I got 4 on the right-hand side. So this value is slap dash in the middle. So therefore, the median is, yes, the median is 4, because it's an odd number of values, so therefore it is right in the middle. Not so bad. I'm sure you could have done that one. The next one. 1 is the smallest number, then 2 is the next one, then 3, okay, there is a 4, again check, is there maybe there's more than 1, be careful, then 5, is there 6, is there 6, no, but there's a 7, is there an 8, no, then there's a 9, and there's a 10. Right, there's a 10, and there's 11, no, there's a 12, is there 13, 14, 15, right, let's again double check, let's count, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 values, let's count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, yes, so I did write down all 10. Let's do our check now. Right. One this side, one this side. One this side, one this side. One this side, one this side. One this side, one. Now I got 2 in the middle. But of course, don't be surprised, guys. Don't be surprised. When I told you an even number of values, you will have 2 in the middle. Now, what do we do with those 2? You still remember? Yes. You say median is 5 plus 7 divided by 2. So you add the 2 in the middle and you divide by 2. 5 plus 7 is 12 divided by 2, and therefore the median is 6. If you know what to do when it's an odd number and what to do if it's an even number of values. Not so difficult. I'm sure you will be able to do that. All right. Let's look at your activity now. The following data set contains the ages in years of a few learners. So there you are. There's the ages. 9 years, 15 years, 11 years, 18 years, and 19 years. Most of them are teenagers. How many ages of learners are in this data set? So you say, how many are there? I think you already answered that question, I think. Is the number of ages an odd or even number? Important. Rank the ages. So another new word. You know, we said ordered, we said arranged, now we say rank. They all mean the same thing, guys. Ordered, rank, they all mean the same thing. You must write them in from smallest to biggest. And, of course, what is the median? All right, so I'm going to give you a few minutes to do this one. Again, you can do it on your own. You can work with your friend. Starting now. Right, welcome back, guys. Now, let's just quickly look at what the answer is. And the median, I'm looking at question D now, right? Question D. And if I have a quick look, sometimes you must try and do these things also mentally, you know. If I have a quick look, it looks like 15. And you can double check. The median is 15. But please, guys, do the other questions as part of your homework. Okay, right now, part of the homework itself. And there's your homework. There's question one. The height in centimeters of grade 9 learners are given in the table below. So there's your table. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20 values. You must rank them. I remember again what the meaning of rank. You must order them. How many are they in the data set? What is the modal height? Modal is derived from mode. So don't be shocked when you see the word modal. It just means mode. What is the median? And what is the mean? So you see, it's a mixed bag of all what we've discussed today. So please, this is your homework. I think that is the only question we have. Please, guys, do it as homework. Educators, please make sure that learners do it. And please, the next day, or maybe even today, there's time, mark it and make sure that you can do it. All right. So, guys, thank you for being with me. I really enjoyed teaching you, and I hope that central tendency makes more sense to you now. All right. So, please, guys, have a lovely day and see you next time. Bye-bye.